All right, I gotta go. Love you, Mom. Bye.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to HYM, the show, our special Mother's Day edition. Hope you guys are all doing well. We had a great week. So Austin turned, my oldest Austin, he turned 11 this past week. And so we decided to throw him a birthday parade. And boy, was he surprised. So here, check out a brief clip from that parade that we recorded. So enjoy this little birthday celebration parade that we had for Austin. One thing you didn't see from that clip was that Austin was literally just crying the whole time for the parade. He was just so moved by all the people coming out to show up for his birthday. So that was a lot of fun this past week. And so thank you to those who were at youth group last Sunday. That's where I was. Now you know why I was at youth group. We were celebrating Austin's 11th birthday. But so coming up on this special Mother's Day edition show today, we have 60 Seconds with Joel, Mother's Day edition. So we'll have Sage as well as her mom Molly on the Zoom call with her. So looking forward to that. We're gonna take a couple minutes and look at a passage from Philippians chapter 2. Passage really kind of reminds me of moms as well. So have fun, spend a couple minutes there. Philippians 2. We have coming up later in the show, top 10 reasons why I love mom. So that'll be fun. And then we're gonna end up with a special outro, a little surprise coming up at the end of the show. So we're excited about this. We love moms. So this whole episode going out to all the mothers that we know and that we love in our lives. So without further ado, let's get right into 60 Seconds and Joel. Welcome, Sage and Molly. Thanks so much
for taking the time to join us on 60 Seconds, Joel, our special Mother's Day edition. So happy Mother's Day to you. So you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. I'm going to start the timer starting now. All right, so first question. Is cereal soup?
No.
Okay. I was confident, no. What is invisible but you wish you could see?
I think emotions.
I'm stealing that from her because I like that too.
Nice. How do you feel about putting pineapple on top of pizza?
Absolutely not. No.
It's so good. Hawaiian pizza. It's so good. What is the best kind of cheese?
All cheese. I'm sorry, go first.
American.
All cheese. Love all cheese.
My mom is gourmet cheese.
If you got arrested, what would it be for?
Being too loud.
Disturbing the peace.
Yeah.
And mine would be protesting something, but protesting something like good.
Nice. If animals could talk, which would be the rudest?
A woodpecker.
I say, or could it be an insect like a hornet?
Okay, go for it, yeah. What is your favorite ice cream flavor?
Vanilla.
Vanilla, like salted caramel.
Ooh, that's good. Boom, that was 60 seconds.
Oh, bummer. We got to talk faster.
That's right. We didn't get through them all, but here, we'll do one more. Okay. I liked, what TV family is your family?
I think the Goldbergs.
The Goldbergs?
Yeah.
And she's probably right. It's the Goldbergs. I'm just a little bit like the mom. Just a little. Mm-hmm. Stop.
No,
like in a good way.
In a good way, but like more than a little.
In a good way, though. Have you watched
you're
that
so
show?
An Erica.
I have. Yeah.
Sage, you're so an Erica.
Thanks.
We have the peanut gallery back here.
That's right. Hey, how you doing, Dane?
Good. How are you, Joel?
Doing well. That's too funny. Well, thanks for taking a minute to help us out.
Thank you for letting us.
Yeah, thanks for inviting us. That was fun.
Absolutely. As I was thinking about Mother's Day coming up this past week, and I was drawn back to this passage from Philippians chapter 2 that really you know, kind of, as I was reading it again, kind of just like, man, this talks about mothers and the love that they have, not only for their own kids and for their own family, but for everybody around them. Because here in Philippians chapter 2, Paul writes that we are to have the same mindset as Jesus, right? Because Jesus's life was full of difficulty. Jesus had every reason to complain, but never did. And even though Jesus was divine in nature, right, being fully God, he was also fully man. But he never used his equality with God to his advantage. He humbled himself and he took position as a servant, right? Keeping that in mind, think about the things that we complain about all the time. Why is the internet so slow? There's no food in the house. Are we there yet? Right? Jesus didn't deserve the pain that he endured, right? He never once protested, right? That kind of behavior gets someone's attention. And as I look back on this passage verse, I'm going to share some of it. And as I read this, right, think about your mom or the women in your life who have that kind of motherly role in your lives. See, here in Philippians 2, I'm going to start at the beginning. It says, therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interest, but each of you to the interests of the others. In your relationship with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus. Right? That's our mothers. That's the women who our life are so willing to give up the things that they want, the desires they have, not because they feel like they have to, but because they want to. So this Mother's Day, make sure you take the time, go out of your way to let your mom know that you love them, to let the other women in your life to know how much you value them, how thankful you are for them, and how they just go out of their way time and time again to love on you, right? Show them your gratitude. Doesn't matter how many times we complain, doesn't matter how many times we do things that we know our moms will get upset with us for. They will always, always love us, right? And they, right, as they pour into Christ's love, right, that's where our mothers get their strength and their endurance from. So, do that not just today because it's Mother's Day, but do it every day. Find some way to go out of your way every day to let your mom know that you love her and are so thankful for all the things that she does in your life. Which moves us on to our next segment, which is the top 10 reasons why I love my mom. So here we go. This should be good. This isn't just, you know, the top 10 reasons why I love my mom, because some of these sure definitely do fit into why I love my mom, but right, it's the top 10 reasons why we as a group of people love moms. Here we go. Number 10. For always laughing at my jokes, even when they're not funny. Number 9. For never taking a sick day. Number 8. For being the prettiest alarm clock I know. Number 7. For always being the loudest and most obnoxious cheerleader on the sidelines. Number 6. For being my personal 6-star rated Uber driver. Number 5, for always putting others before herself. Number 4, for being the only person in the world to be able to get the grass stains out of my favorite jeans. Number 3, for always giving me a hug even when I say I don't want one. Number 2, for preparing a nightly all-you-can-eat buffet. And the number 1 reason why I love my mom, because you're my mom. So those are the top 10 reasons why I love my mom. So thank you to all our mothers out there. Thanks for tuning in to HYM, the show, our Mother's Day edition. And as we end this episode, take a look at these pictures, honoring you, all the mothers out there. So thanks for all your love. Have a great week. See you guys next week. Thank you.